Do you have a business email? Do you know how to make one? Well, if you're interested, stick around for this video because that's what we're going to cover today. Hi everyone, I hope you're all doing well. If you're new here, my name is Greg and I like to talk about online entrepreneurship. So if you're interested in making money online, feel free to look around the channel and you might find some stuff that you like. In today's video, I'm going to walk you through step-by-step how to create a business email. Now quickly, before we get started, the video that I'm about to show you is actually from a course that I'm working on putting together for you guys on how to start a service business. And the video that I'm about to show you is one of the lectures in the course, but I really think it can be a great standalone video here on YouTube. Once I finish up the entire course, I'll link it down in the description. But in the meantime, let's get right into how to create a business email. So the very first thing I recommend you do is go over to Google Domains or domains.google and purchase your website name or your business domain name over there. This is going to be the tail end of your business email. So whatever you want this to say, purchase that domain. Now, most of the domains over there are only $12 a year, which I absolutely love about Google Domains. So you're probably only going to pay $1 a month for this domain name. You can link it right to your website, wherever you're hosting that. And then actually linking it up to create a business email is completely free to do. So without further ado, let's get into the video tutorial on step-by-step creating this business email. Okay, so this is going to be a really important part right here, and this is creating an email address that you can use that ends with at whatever domain name you just purchased. So this is really important for your reputation and looking professional with your service business, and I'm going to show you how to do it for free. So once you have the domain name purchased, and I'm just going to use one that I own for example here, then come down to email. And it's going to offer that you can pay something around $5 per month for Google to do this for you. But speaking from experience, I'm going to show you how to do it for free. It's just a couple extra steps. So the very first thing we need to do is put in your name right here and then at whatever domain name you have and then where you're going to forward that to. So what this is going to do is create an email forward, and you can create up to 100 of these. So we'll put in your name here and then where it's going to send to, and this is going to be your email address. Now I recommend, if you don't already have a Gmail account, then I recommend you Google Gmail, and this is Google's email provider, and just go over to Gmail and create an email address there, because then you can download the Gmail app on your phone and you can easily receive emails and send emails from the address that we're about to create, and that address being your name at that domain name. So once you've entered your name here and then that Gmail address where it's going to send to, then just click add. Then there's just one more step. So as far as we are right now, we can put this email address, your name at your domain name.com, anywhere. This can go on business cards, this can go on your website, and people can email this and it'll forward that address to your email. However, we need to set up the feature where we can send from this email address as well. So right now we can receive them, we just can't send emails from this address. So once you have this set up, then we need to come over to our Gmail account and we hit the little settings icon right here. And then we hit accounts and import and we click add another email address. Now go ahead and type in what that email address is that we just created over here, and then make sure that this is turned on. Treat as an alias, and this means that it's going to be shown as this address, but behind the scenes it's going to be sent from our Gmail account. So once you've typed this into here, that's good. Just make sure that the name is how you want it to show up when you send from your business email. Do you want it to be your first and last name? Do you want it to be your first name and then at whatever your company is? However you want to set that there, I've done it both ways for different businesses, but that's up to you. But once you have these two set here and you have this turned on, then we hit next step. And this is where a lot of people get confused. So this is how we want to do it here. So a couple of things, we're going to change the domain name that it sets right here to Gmail. So we have smtp.gmail.com. We'll switch the port over to 465. And then this is going to be the username for the Gmail account. So the actual email it's going to be sending from, not this one over here. So make sure that it's actually the Gmail account that we're logged into in the background here, and then the password to that Gmail account. And then keep this set on SSL and just hit add account. Easy as that. And then all you'll have to do is hit verify address, and it'll send an email to this email, which will forward back to your Gmail, and you'll get an email that pops up right in your Gmail account or your Gmail app. And that will have the PIN that you can verify this account. And that way you can receive emails at this email address and you can send them through the Gmail app or through your Gmail dashboard. Just make sure that when you're sending the email over on Gmail, you're switching who it's being sent from your standard Gmail over to your business Gmail. So that is a very important step. If you need to rewatch this lecture to make sure you get all the steps in order, definitely make sure you do that. But then you will have a professional email account that you can use to receive emails and send emails for your service business, and all completely for free. All right, guys, that's it for this one. I hope you enjoyed this video and I hope it was helpful for you. If you have any questions at all, feel free to leave them down in the comments, and I'll see you guys in the next video.